I listened to a company called Vodai Metrics with me, my brother, and my sister. But unfortunately, my brother traveled somewhere and was not able to come here. He has got typhoid. So I really miss him a lot, and he was there, the presentation would have been much more better. And so I'll today be talking about mobile app piracy. So first of all, before we go and get into mobile app piracy, I just want to talk a little bit of our company. So we develop apps for the iOS and Android platform in the stuff of games, education, lifestyle, and consumers. So our apps. So we basically have developed 5 apps from the App Store, which is now released. And so the first app which we developed is called Catch Me Cop. Catch Me Cop is a game where you're the notorious con and you've escaped from the prison. So there's a nationwide hunt for you. And so this this app was rated 4.5 stars on the iOS app of gaming type. And so Alphabet Board is alphabet learning app which teaches you the alphabet without you having the help of an adult. And so this is a very, very useful app, and it gives you also the meaning of the gives you an example of the word of the letter, and so that it will be much more easier for you to learn. So Player Planet is our third app. So this app was created in Boston. So actually, we have a small story on this. While we were going on the flight, there was lots of turbulence. So we were wanting to go and play golf, but we didn't have an idea since we had gone and checked in the past. So that's why we got an idea that if we had an app, it would have been so much more easier. So we developed this app, and this is called Player Planet, and this got 4.5 on the Apple. So Color Palette is our latest app, and got 5 star on the Apple website. And this for learning colors, for the children to learn colors, and we have added lots of new features, such as you can go and mix two colors, such as red and orange, and then you get them. So everything is inside one app. And so the latest app which we have developed is called Emergency Booth. So Emergency Booth is mainly for emergency situations. I read the newspaper and I saw that there are lots of problems happening because they were not able to go and call the police and all the evacuation stuff at the right time, and that's why they lots of problems have been happening. So I got an idea that if it would have just been one click of button and then they come, it would have been so much more easier. So if you won't click the button, then everybody near the area can go and they get an SMS like, okay, there's the police are trying to come, so please try to evacuate, and then they can just go and move. So this is for fire and medical and police. And we also have something called the panic button, where actually before I get into panic, you can add 2 friends or contacts, like who live close to you or somebody of your close relatives. But like if there is an emergency situation, then they'll get a message on it, so they'll try to act more faster. So that's the panic button. And now if I go to a different country, I have to go and check on the internet. Okay, this is the number which I have to call, and I have to go and keep on trying to remember it. Since nowadays for lots of numbers, like there are for Mali and stuff, there is about a 9-digit number, so it's quite tough to remember. So that's why if you just go and click on the country menu, you can just go and change the country in just a click of one. And these apps are available on the Apple App Store. So currently, even for the Google App Store, we have started to develop, and we have 3 apps over on the Google Play Store. Of over 21,000 downloads from over 42 countries. what virus? It's not something new that has started. It has been over in about thousands of years. So it actually started from the main world pirates. So these pirates were wanting for gold and money and stuff like that. But nowadays the new, and they used to have like those some eye patches, and they used to have swords and all that stuff. And they used to look scary, but now they're sleek. They have keychain swords, and they have keys, and they have cool goggles. And so, and what do these people want? They want movies, music, softwares, and games, and applications on the mobile. So, which is copyright violation and infringement. Now, the impact of piracy. It's by you just going and buying a CD from the market nearby your house. It does not just go and affect that producer of the movie or something. It affects, there is a social impact. The music companies and stuff are losing $12 billion of over a year value. And then the software industry loses billions of dollars in about $59 billion is now the current industry reports. So, and there's a social impact as well. It's not just that the producer of the company like goes and gets affected. It's even the people who are selling the popcorn. Like in the movie theater, people will just go and buy it from the local shops, and then the theater will stop, and then the person who's selling popcorn will also lose his job. So this is also there's also a lot of loss of jobs, and the impact of innovation. So if you go check in the software industry, they spend about billions and billions of dollars for doing one small application. But what we're going to do is, if you're just going to go and jailbreak your iPhone or something, and just go and get it from the App Store, instead of getting it from the App Store, then they'll think like, what's the use? I've spent billions of dollars and I don't get that billion back to me. So let me stop doing this. Then everybody's going to stop doing their business and he'll be having nothing to do. So this also impacts innovation. And so mobile app piracy. And mobile app piracy is fast growing. And the mobile app ecosystem is helping of the food spread, because you don't have to go and first go register and stuff like that with the government and stuff. And so this, the whole app stuff is supposed to be coming by Forrester reviews and stuff like that. They went and they checked, and they said that it's about $101 billion business in next by 2017. And so this is the Gen X piracy, and this is on the rise. So the story of iPhone. iPhone is supposed to be considered as the most, the most secure, but it's in the hands of the pirates. They have stuff like Cydia, the Red Snow, Lumera 1N, and Green Poison and stuff like that. And so what they do is they jailbreak your phone. So what jailbreak means is that it unlocks it and it gets some apps, and you have to write special URL code, and then you go and you get the app. And for the Android phones, they're supposed to be prone to be much more easier, because it's an open system, so which makes it simpler for the pirates. And the malwares are they don't have any code signing, so that's why it makes so much more problem. And so the ways to stop piracy, so we have to go and get lots of people to go and join and start to do all this stuff. And the main thing is, we have to go and make lots of strict rules so that people start doing all this. And already this has been started, like SOPA and FIFA. And the main thing is, we have to educate people for telling them that piracy is bad. Don't go and buy a CD immediately to the shop running. And go to the movie and watch this. After some time, go and buy the game. And so that's So the technologies solutions are licensing and user authentication. And the main thing is you guys are the people who are doing engineering and stuff. So you people are supposed to go and invent something and stop piracy. So that's it. And thank you. So this is our website and this is our URL code.
Thank you.